Always have to have it your way, don't you?
That's not what you should be saying. I think you meant to say, thank you, Muggy Lou, my best friend.
Yeah, sure. Thank you, Muggy Lou, my best friend. But so we're clear, I'm staying alive on my own terms. Hey, Muggy Lou, I just remembered something. You still haven't given me that 100 gold you owe me.
Why, I have no earthly idea what this 100 gold is that you're talking about.
Don't play dumb with me. It's 100 gold. Pay up.
Ooh, cold as ever. I think I saw icicles coming out of your mouth. I risked my life accompanying you on your quest for revenge, and now you want me to give you 100 gold on top? Well, I've had enough of this treatment. I'm going home.
Okay then. So long.
Trying to stop me! Surely you can appreciate that a feisty fighter such as myself is indispensable to your efforts to take- There's still time to make amends. I can ignore these transgressions under the right condition.
Okay. If either of us gets swallowed up by Enominat, the other one has to pay her 100 gold.
Hmm? You lost me there.
We're betting 100 gold on who gets eaten by Enominat. If you win, your debt will be wiped clean. You can't complain about that.
Oh, I can complain, believe me! Bringing up this 100 gold that I'm not even obligated to pay, hiding your kindness behind your cold words, and I'm just getting started complaining! Do you think I wouldn't notice this attempt to take advantage of an emotional witch to manipulate me into helping you defeat Enominat?
Mogulu,
I'm putting down 100 bajillion gold! That's how much you'll owe me if you make it out alive! You have 3 seconds to back out! 3, 2, 1... Zero! Bet's on for real now! I'll have to stick around for my money. I guess I have no choice but to help defeat Enominat and Artorias and to bring you back in one piece.
You always have to have it your way, don't you?
That's not what you should be saying. I think you meant to say, thank you, Mogulu, my best friend!
Yeah, sure. Thank you, Mogulu, my best friend. But so we're clear, I'm staying alive on my own terms, not just because you told me to.
And you say I'm the one who always has to have it my way. But think twice before trying to put one over on the great witch Mogulu, she who delivers retribution and comeuppances! If I cared, that is, which I don't.
Good luck out there.
Show him how I freed
Do you really think we'll be able to win?
I'd like to just tell you not to worry about it, but I know that can't be helped. In my mind, too much worry can make you lose battles you should be able to win.
I wish I knew how to be like you. I mean, except for turning into a demon.
It's just about keeping your mind calm, isn't it? Me, I try to think about what I'm gonna do after a big fight. Like, what I'm gonna have to eat, or what I'm gonna read next. Anything like that.
All right then, let me ask. What do you plan on doing when this battle is all over?
Hmm?
You've already beaten Lord Shigure. Once Lord Artorias and Enominat are out of the picture, there'll be no better sword fighter in the whole world. What exactly will you set your sights on next in life?
First of all, I still have a ways to go before I'm truly better than Shigure.
What? But you've already beat him!
Only by fighting with 3 blades. If we had matched Greatsword against Greatsword, I wouldn't have been on his level. Besides, it's a big world. The next great opponent could be out there anywhere.
You really are a man of unassailable conviction, Rokuro.
That's just because I'm a demon. What about you? What'll your next move be?
I want to keep doing whatever I can to help people. Not as an exorcist, but as another human being. Just to give you a fair warning. If you ever attack humans like other demons do, I won't hesitate to take you down.
Oh yeah? I'm pretty tough, you know.
Don't worry about me. When we win this battle, I'll have the confidence I need to become even stronger.
Then I guess you've answered your initial question.
Yeah. Let's go. We have a fight to win.
Damn straight!
Even after we defeat Enominat, you'll still be able to see me normally, right, Aizen?
Yeah. We spiritual beings like Malakim and demons will still be aware of each other like before. But nearly every human will stop seeing us, just like Mogulu said. Does that make you sad?
Doesn't it make you sad? I mean, Benwick and the other pirates won't be able to see you and...
It doesn't matter whether they can see me or not. They already know that I'll always be right there with them. When I go back to being a ghost to them, I'll be sure to make their voyages very interesting.
Oh, yeah! Back before they could see you, they thought you were a ghost haunting their ship.
Yeah. It'll be just like old times again.
So, your life will go on, alongside the pirates and their ship, even if they can't see you?
But our eventual parting is inevitable. That's something we can never escape as Malakim. For we live far longer than any human. Parting is always hard. If you don't want that pain, the only way to avoid it is to shun all contact with humans. Some Malakim never leave our heavenly realm, where the conflicts of foolish men are but distant rumble, hardly felt or heard. But to me, humans are an inspiration. Living to their fullest with the limited time they have.
Yeah.
Not that Malakim are immortal, either. We have our own ends to face, myself included. I don't know if that day will come in 500 years or 1,000, or even tomorrow. So I choose to live here with them, moment by moment, giving it everything I've got.
Benwick and the other pirates know how you feel. That's why you won't be sad when they can no longer see you.
Yeah, I believe that's true.
But I...
It's okay to feel lost. Let yourself wander for a while. But whatever you end up choosing, decide it for yourself. In the end, that's all that matters.
Yeah. Okay.
If you want to live, get out of my way.